2020, 2021 yan. Yeah. Well, I found out about it. And actually, I was just about to assume office when I found out about it. Mm-hmm. When I did some research. And the president was invited. President PRRT was invited to grace the groundbreaking of that project. So, as usual, the system is for the presidential management staff to do the completed staff work. That's where they found out that the joint venture was entered into by Bucor together with a private corporation without the permission of the DOJ. At that time, Secretary Guevara. So the president didn't go to that groundbreaking. And you know that when there is an unsolicited proposal of that nature, it's supposed to go through a Swiss challenge. There are rules for joint venture agreements and unsolicited proposals. And I cannot accept that because, first of all, I do not want to privatize Bilibid. I do not believe that we should be selling property as a country. Ang tawag natin dyan, patrimonial property of the state. Ano yan eh? Nakatitulo yan sa Republika ng Pilipinas. Sa pag-may-ari niyan, lahat ng taong bayan, kayong lahat may-ari niyan, tayong lahat may-ari niyan. Kaya hindi pwede yan i-dispose na isa kahit isang tao lamang. Kahit mayroong isang batas na sinasabing Bucor Modernization Law, it does not give plenary powers to anybody to dispose of government property. It has to go through a process. Privatization yan eh. Privatization has to go through the council, it has to go through the Department of Finance, it has to be approved by the Secretary of Justice, it has to be approved by the President. Marami hong approval process yan. So, far out yung idea na yan. You have no plenary power. Even the SOJ has no power over that. It has to go through the process.
Sir, do we know the details about the JPA? Kasi may sinasabing 65, 35.
Yes, that's, if I recall, that's the proposal and there's land to be exchanged and they will build the jail. Yung Bilibid, lilipat mo lang sa ibang lugar. So you're still putting up a mega prison somewhere else. And as I told you, Penology does not anymore agree with the idea of a mega prison. The worldwide trend in Penology does not agree with the idea of a mega prison. That's why it's a useless idea. It's not really good for our times. And ang sabi ko nga, I've told my position to the president that if ever we are able to relocate Bilibid, it should be for a government center and for parks purposes so that people in Metro Manila at least have somewhere to go. Diba?
Do we know if the president ultimately disapproved of the project? Because I understand there's a memo from SOJ Guevara recommending the disapproval.
It was never acted upon.
It was not acted upon.
Yes, because ano eh, it's like a midnight deal. Kasi palabas na naman ang palabas na yung administration. And I don't think they were inclined to do that. No? I don't think they were inclined to
Sir,
do that.
Sir, ano maging hasbang natin following the more recent discoveries of
Well, all of that, simply the ombudsman will be informed of all of these developments. It's our duty to inform the ombudsman of all of these developments because apparently some of them are not within legal bounds. No? Some laws will probably have been violated by some of these supposed projects. By the way, no, that was supposed to be a treasure hunt for Yamashita Treasure. Originally, I was told by Director General Bantag about it, and I told him to stop it. I told him to stop it. No, it was supposed to be a treasure hunt. That's what he told me before. Yun ang sinabi niya sa akin. So maybe sometime August or September, he told me about it.
Anong basis niya, sir, for saying that?
Sinabi niya sa akin eh. Bilang sinabi niya, he opened up to me about it. And I told him, huwag mo nang gawin yan. Diba? It's,
Did he have any permit?
I don't know. I have so much on my hands. I cannot inspect every inch of square ground in Bilibid. Eh. Diba? Marami naman tayong trabaho dito. We have 10 agencies under the DOJ.
Sir, ako, question lang ako. Ito po sa UPR.
Yes, yes.
Ask ko lang po kung may mga, Jacob Laza na pala of PBI. May mga tungkol doon sa recommendations na inaccept po.
Yes,
natin.
Yes.
May mga specific instances po ba na nire-refer yung recommendations sa yun, for example, the drug war killings, the Limas detention, journalist killings, ganun po.
Ano yan, ina-accept natin marami dyan eh, no? 200 of them we accepted. Yung hindi lang natin tinanggap dyan, yung mga culturally reprehensible eh.
Like what?
Abortion. I don't think that we're ready for the idea of over-the-counter abortion. I don't think we want that.
Yung sinabi mo, sir, na merong iba na walang solid basis na recommendations.
Well, for example, no, parang automatically in the drug war, EJK na kagad. You should not conclude. You have a conclusion of fact and law when something happens. You don't do that.
Kasama po yun sa mga recommendations.
Marami, marami. There are 297. We accepted 200.
Yung out of the 200, kasama din doon on alleged killings under the drug war.
Ano yan eh? Kasi ano yan eh? That's something that we're doing something about already. The alleged killings under the drug war, we're doing something about that already. So we accept it. Why should you reject something that's there already?
So aside from the drug war, may mga iba po bang cases? For example, the detention of political prisoners or sa yun nga po sa mga media people that they attack, ganun po, disinformation, ganun.
Marami, marami. I don't have the list right now. I'd like to show you the list when we, kasi we have until to, I think December to submit our position on everyone.
Pero sir, ask ko na lang po na after accepting these recommendations, ano po yung next step natin?
Well, we work on it. Kasi some of them, actually most of them are in process already. That's why we accept them. Some of them do not even know that we're already doing it. Some of them don't even know that we already ratified some of the treaties, but just as I say, we accept them.
Sir, 200 more than the same previous 100 pay lang yung accept. Now, 200 recommendations. Is this a sign that the administration is going to be more open to the international community?
I think that's very obvious. I think that's very obvious. We're more open now.
Yeah. More invitations?
They're telling us to rejoin the ICC. Mm-hmm. Yeah, recommendation. Mm-hmm. And that's already something that you have to consult every sector now about. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have to consult the former President Duterte. I have to consult the Senate. Mm-hmm. I have to consult everybody who wishes to look into the ICC, rejoining the ICC. Because as far as we are concerned, we're not Sudan or we're not an African country in trouble that has no government running the show. So, di ba? It's ano yan eh? You always think about if it's practical, necessary, or beneficial for your country. You do not jump in and say, oh, because they said, I'll do it. No, you don't do that.
Pero sir, ask ko lang, ano sa tingin niyo dun sa 287, yung may pinakamaraming recommendations na similar topic? Similar issue?
I cannot recall. Press freedom?
Press freedom.
I think we have the freest press in the world. I think you know that, di ba?
Sir, check, balik na ako kay Bantag.
Yes,
sir. Sir, kasi patong-patong na yung issues hounding Bantag. Will you formally ask the President to dismiss the Bantag?
When I have the chance. It's not very urgent to me right now. Because he's still under preventive suspension anyway. No? And that automatically gives him a hold or departure order because you cannot travel without a travel permit when you are a member of government. Di ba? So, there's a convenience to it. And you're subject to the laws of this country.
Diba?
Wala pa akong update, no? I think they're still both here. I don't see any reason for them to leave. Or there are no travel records right now.
Sir, nagkaka-problem sa pag-serve ng subpoena sa kanila?
Their last known address yan. Last known address. The 201 file, in his employment record, will be the one to give you where his last known address is.
Would you want to answer, sir, some of the allegations of Director General Bantag? For example, yung video daw ni Percy Lapid.
Hindi, ito yan, no? Name-calling is the name of the game, no?
Okay.
I do not engage in that. I think at our level here, we do not do that. And I don't think media should even give it at the time of day to for people to go name-calling. Let's elevate the profession to a better level, di ba? Walang ganun lang.
Specific allegations, sir, like yung kumuha daw ng video was under
Well, ano yun eh? Prove it, di ba? Wala naman eh. These are bare allegations of it. I don't wanna say anything.
Sir, yung sir, allegedly may dalawang nasa WPP daw na gusto ninyong palayain na PDA.
I have no knowledge of that. I have no
Agoho,
knowledge of that.
Sir. Herman Agoho, sir.
Agoho.
Well, we tried talking to him about siyempre, sinubukan natin kausapin. Ayaw niya mag-cooperate.
Ayaw mag-cooperate.
So far, wala.
Hindi siya tinuturo ni Escorial.
No, his name was mentioned by another informant. That's why we picked him up. That's why we asked to talk to him. But he hasn't shown any cooperation or knowledge. Sabi niya wala siyang knowledge. Well, we can find out. Batangas group. Kasi from Batangas ago. Yeah.
So that's it lang? Walang anything?
Yeah, something like Batangas group, Dimakulangan brothers, former handlers of Dimakulangan, prior when they were still at large.
Sir, marami pong nadidiscover si DJ Katapa ngayon sa NDP. Isa nga daw po dun sa...
We expect more.
Sir, may mga sawa daw, tapos may mga kabayo na allegedly for patrolling, yung sawa for pest control.
Ayan, there's a Latin term for that. Diba? That's ipsa loquitur.
Sir, anong masasabi mo diba? Sa sinabi?
Nothing speaks for itself.
Sir, anong masasabi mo sa sinabi ng Senator Trillon? Napaka yung mga testimonial evidence hindi po tanggapin ng court.
Bakit?
Para dito kayo.
Why not?
Kasi daw,
it's the job of the prosecution to present the evidence. And the speculative.
Sir, merong view for inmates na nagkwento na they were brutally tortured while in custody. Is that something that you will look into?
Of course. Those are serious allegations. No? A person, even if he's deprived of liberty, does not lose all his rights. Maybe you may not have the right to communication. You cannot use a telephone inside. Maraming curtailment of right na legal. Pero hindi lahat ng rights mo mawawala. And torture definitely is a right that nobody loses for the rest of his life, for anybody at all.
So you will be meeting now with ICRC representatives this afternoon? International Committee of the Red Cross?
Yes, my staff has scheduled the meeting. If it's my equivalent, I will talk to them. But if it's not my equivalent in rank, I leave it to the undersecretaries to do it.
Sir, doon pa rin sa kay Bantag, next week po yung PI for him. Pero ngayon pa lang, sir, sinabi na niya na kung magka-arrest warrant, hindi po siya magsusurrender as long as you are the SOJ.
Well, up to him. His lawyers know better. He should ask his lawyers what he should do. Diba?
Pero sir, ito pong nakita natin na yung tungkol dun sa JVA and all the other things. Simula pa lang ba ito? Marami pa po ba tayong
interview? Hindi, matagal na yung JVA na yan eh. Kasi nga, nangyari yan during the past administration eh. Hindi ko binigyan ng pansin yan kahit kailan eh. There were attempts to task me to amend the JVA so that they can still get stop in. Sabi ko, no. It's not for me. Kasi gusto ko yan, maging government center. Ang bilibid, alam nyo, napakahirap bumili ng lupa para sa gobyerno. Benta tayo ng benta. Pag kailangan na natin lupa, hindi tayo makabili. Sobrang naman, di ba? Wala naman ganun na.
Sir, pero sa Nueva Ecija, ano na ang magiging plans? Kasi I understand, nag-visit kayo
sa... Yung minimum security pa rin ang atin gusto ilipat muna ron. So ma-decongest ang Bucor dito sa Muntinlupa habang ginagawa natin ang regionalization. Okay. We just want everything to be better, to improve the conditions of confinement of all of these persons deprived of liberty.
But that will be an entirely government project, walang private partner?
Walang private partner ron. Of course, there are proposals to privatize jail management, no? But I will not go for that yet. I think it's too early for this country to think about it. But if there are proposals, we'll look at it. If that's the trend around the world, we'll look at how they're performing, if it's worth our money.
Sir, kailan ito determahan yung IRR ng pag-up ng mga...
Malama, mamaya, this afternoon.
Sir, yung ombudsman ba dapat pwede pumasok na yung ombudsman doon sa issue ng JDA?
Motu proprio, they can actually enter into an investigation. Motu proprio.
Or pa-file nyo research sa ombudsman?
We will cooperate. Whatever documents there are here, but it was never submitted to the DOJ kasi. It was done as an independent republic of Bucor, dealing with the private sector. Hindi niya sinama ang DOJ noon, tsaka hindi niya rin sinama ang Office of the President, hindi niya sinama ang Department of Finance.
Autopsy 7, may update na po ba?
Wala pa. I just came home last night.
Sir, sinasabi ni General Bantag so many things, no? Pero sinachallenge din po niya kayo to resign that allegedly wala na daw po kayong moral assembly.
I won't even answer that. And then,
so sir, yung makita treasure yung binibinisan yung nakabukay
doon? Yes, that's what he told me.
May nakita po.
I don't know.
Anong reaction niyo nung sinabi niya yun sa inyo?
Yeah, kasi ridiculous nga eh. Tsaka, you're wasting government time and money eh, di ba? Eh, hindi ko alam kung government time and money ginamit niya, pero ridiculous para sa akin eh. You're not there to seek for treasure, you're there to run the corrections department.
Pero how long na daw, sir? Kasi ang sinasabi 6 months ago, pero sa lalim na po.
Hindi ko alam eh. Hindi ko alam. Actually, I have no idea. We were too busy with other things, believe me. This department has so much to handle. Alam niyo naman yan eh, di ba?
Oh. Tatabunan po ba yun, sir? Kung ano, hindi na talaga pansigin yung contract and everything, by the end of the day, tatabunan po ba yun?
Hindi ko alam eh. Hindi ko alam. I have to check what happened there.
Okay.
Tsaka, saan nagpunta yung filling material? Mm. Kasi that's a lot of money. This filling material is worth a lot of money also.
Okay.
Thank you,
sir. Asik, marinig kami interview kay SOJ kanina. The question about the joint venture agreement. So, apparently, walang alam yung Department of Justice about it. Pwede yung pakukwento sa amin what really happened about that supposed joint venture between you for and Atom Corporation?
Well, this came out of the interview of suspended Director General Bantag, no, on a certain radio station, and he mentioned something about the joint venture. So we looked into it just to make sure that what he was saying was actually true, and we did actually find a memorandum from the former Secretary Guevara to the President then, President Pirardi, advising him that the joint venture agreement supposedly entered into between si Director General Bantag of Bucor and Atom was a void ab initio. So the recommendation was basically to not approve, no? And because this falls under the BOT law, it requires the consent and approval of the President then. So the memorandum did recommend the disapproval of the joint venture agreement. Yes, so there were issues about the nature of it being an unsolicited proposal. Kasi marami kasing requirements yun eh. There's an unsolicited proposal, subject to a Swiss challenge, but it seems as though it was unilateral. So the bidding process, I believe, was not gone through. Tapos other requirements, documentary requirements, were also not complied with. So, these are the things that we're looking at. I have yet to read the full report, but it seems as though the agreement did not push through. So there is no joint venture agreement to speak of because it requires the consent and approval of the President before entering.
The President did not give his consent. Do you have any document at any MECO that would show na hindi natuloy? Was there any memo from ES Media Lea in response?
I have yet to see any document in response to the recommendation. What I have so far is the recommendation for the disapproval. But I think the lack of the JVA or the absence of the JVA is already indicative that there's indeed no JVA.
But did the DOJ at least have a copy of the proposed JVA, even the unsigned one?
Well, I don't have one yet, Attorney Mike. Yeah.
So what will happen now? Given these allegations by the Secretary of SOJ, Boy Rimbulya, can you do anything about it, especially on the JVA?
I think we're doing things one step at a time. Nauna kasi yung, siyempre yung murders, no, the twin murders of Percy Lapid and June Villamor. Nandun pa tayo. So all these things came out as a result of his statements, the former Director General's statements on media. And I think we'll really just have to go one step at a time muna kasi parang ang dami ng issues eh. So we'll stick to one first and then we'll thresh out the rest properly before we get into it.
Another question, Asik, is can a Bucor Director General actually enter into such a big deal with an outside corporation considering the nature involved? You're transferring the whole national penitentiary to the BCA. You're making a joint venture 65-35% agreement with a follow-up question. Can the Beaufort director alone decide on this without letting the DOJ or at least the SOJ know about it?
As per the recommendation and the legal study that was conducted by our legal team here in the DOJ, it seems like that's not allowed because under the BOT law, which was the applicable law found applicable here by the legal team, kailangan ng approval ng DOJ and ultimately the President of the Philippines. Well, I think the best person to answer that is the panel of prosecutors. Yeah, the best persons to ask about that are the panel of prosecutors. Once we file the case, the NBI or PNP filed the case kasi, hindi na kami masyadong nakikialam dun sa discretion ng mga prosecutors. So yung proseso na yun ay binibigay na lang natin sa prosecutors so that they can do their job properly. Yes, we're looking more into it kasi yung mga reports kasi natin puro unverified pa. Kaya gusto namin talaga tignan yung the documentation that was involved in that joint venture and we'll go from there kasi ngayon pa puro unvalidated, puro unverified pa yung mga reports natin. I just want to be sure before I speak on anything. As far as we know, Attorney Mike, it's only the fact that they are based, their company based in Nueva Ecija. So I'm not sure if there's any more information. If ever there is, I haven't been informed yet.
Balikan lang natin yung sa joint venture. Kailan nagsimula? What do we know so far dun sa pinasok nila?
I only know, alam ko lang yung legalities nun na may recommendation, may legal study na ginawa ang DOJ. And as per the legal study and the recommendation, hindi daw approved by, well, it's not subject to approval or the recommendation was for the disapproval of the joint venture agreement. Yun lang naman ang alam namin so far. Yeah, I'll read it first. Basahin ko muna. Okay. Right, okay. Yeah, sure.
Uh-oh. Update dun sa mga inautopsy ni Dr.
Well, she mentioned that she can do about 5 cadavers in 2 days. So I believe there's about 160 to 170 cadavers. So we'll just have to wait until she's finished with all the autopsies para magawa na niya ng report yon. And on that basis, again, we will act appropriately. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.